Lavity Digestive Endoscopy Center create FC Endoscopy Series for Endoscopy Education. This is FC ERCP Series. There are 10 topics to be presented. I would like to express our gratitude to Professor Nontri Pausawat, the President Thai Association for Gastrointestinal Endoscopy, to support and endorse this program.And also thanks Boston Scientific Thailand to please support as well. And also I would like to express our thanks to our colleague, Dr. Thayaporn Chandrasiri, who draw this beautiful medical illustration in this program. This program will focus on practical points to perform ERCP successfully and safely. FC ERCP series number 3.Syndrome and endoscopic papillary balloon dilation. In 1974, President Kawai and Professor Cousins introduced endoscopic syndrome in the same year. This the gateway for endoscopic pancreatobiliary intervention. This topic starts with syndrome. I will discuss on equipment, accessory, indication, technique,and how to avoid adverse event. Start with equipment and accessory. You need ERCP equipment and syndrome for syndrome KY and midnight papillotomy in some particular case, of course, electrosurgical unit. Indication. Indication for syndrome is stone removal, follicular removal, stent placement,insert cholangioscope for cholangioscopy, and some contraction need to be addressed, concern, need to collect in group of the coagulopathy, and the patient with antiplatelet need to properly prepare before procedure, and in case of poor direction to cut, recommend to change from syndrome to balloon dilation. The technique.This is the study of arterial supply of the major donor papilla and is relevant to endoscopic sphincterotomy from 19 cadaveric pancreatorectomy specimen. You can see 11 to 12 o'clock is the best location for biduct sphincterotomy and 1 to 2 o'clock is the best for PD sphincterotomy.Technique in detail of biliary syndrome. Insert the syndrome or the wire inside the biduct. Keep good resection of the ampulla, especially to see the suprapapillary fold. If you cannot see, you can put the syndrome and fully bow and pull back. Or you can put the balloon in, bow the balloon and then pull back. You can see more suprapapillary fold clearly. Place 1/3 to halfOf the distal cutting wire inside the papilla, check proper electrosurgical setting, and keep the sharp locator attached to the loop wall. Bend the cutting wire to attach the loop of papilla. Use the right hand to measure the sharp of scope to control direction and cut the wire by press the yellow pedal. Keep in 11 o'clock and the maximum not far away from suprapapillary fold.Adequate syndrome, you can see the bile come out, and when you fully bend the syndrome, you can put catheter in and out freely. For the pancreatic syndrome, same technique, but cut in 1 to 2 o'clock. This is biliary syndrome in 11 o'clock. This pancreatic duct syndrome in 1 o'clock direction. This short video clip, you can see.Place the syndrome attached to the wall, blow the cutting wire, use the right hand to control the sharp scope, and cut in 11 o'clock until you reach the maximum of the suprapapillary fold. For the patient with surgically altered anatomy, different in terms of the scope that you use. If you use ERCP scope, it will be reversed.Direction, CBD in 5 o'clock and PD in 7 o'clock. But if you use NVU scope, for example, endoscope, colonoscope, or even gastroscope, you can face the normal ampulla and the normal direction, CBD in 11 to 12 o'clock, PD in 1 to 2 o'clock. And for the liver ampulla, you can cannulate with the catheter or you can use rotatable syndrome. And for the dilatation, you can use balloon for dilatation, for example, hurricane balloon or say balloon, or you can cut with rotatable syndrome or B2 syndrome. In difficult situation that you need to make syndrome, you can insert the stent first and you use the knife to cut the sphincter over the stent. How to avoid adverse event? The most common adverse event is blood bleeding. So you need to check, especially for the high risk of the bleeding, cirrhotic patient, chronic renal failure, cardiomyopathy, the patient or antiplatelet or anticoagulant, you need to be prepared and be careful in case of the acute cholangitis because of inflammation of the ampulla, and cut the good direction in 11 o'clock. Especially be careful in case of the preambular diverticulum. This slide to show you how to prepare the patient on antiplatelet or on anticoagulant. This proposed by Professor Todd Barlon in ESP book 2018. If bleeding occurs during you make syndrome, do not panic. The most important to keep the wire inside the bile duct and water irrigation. If you cannot see the area of the bleeding clearly, recommend to blow the balloon and to compress for a few minutes and then to liberate. If you can see clearly the poor bleeding, you can control with different of the accessory, Quercaspar, needle injection, GoProbe, hemospray, or even the fully covered metal stent. The best way to avoid perforation, do not cut beyond the suprapapillary fold. Not beyond this area, this title of perforation. Move to next topic, EPBD, endoscopic papillary balloon dilation. There are two techniques. The first technique, EPBD, use small diameter of balloon, not more than 10 mm diameter, and usually perform without syndrome. The second technique, EPLBD, endoscopic papillary large balloon dilatation. Use large balloon from 12 mm in diameter, dilate with or without prior syndrome. Anyway, generally recommend to prior syndrome to minimize in terms of post-posterior pancreatitis. Indication for bigger stone that cannot remove by either syndrome or EPBD. And contraction need to be concerned in case of severe cryopathy need to be collect and unrecommend to use in non-bile duct dilatation, distal bile duct suture, and post-acute pancreatitis. The technique, Bailey sphincterplasty. Technique in detail, deep cannulation over the guide wire, keep in cooperation to see the ampulla, and you pick up the balloon. For the EPBD, you fix the balloon with hurricane 8 to 10 mm, depend on the diameter of the bile duct. For the EPLBD, normally we cut sphincter 50 to 75% first, and then insert the CE balloon. This is a proper criteria to perform EPLBD. You can see on the left hand side, this is a dilated bile duct down to the ampulla. But on the right hand side, this is a normal, narrow CBD that's not fit for this EPLBD technique. And the side balloon, you can measure the proper size of the maximum of CE balloon. And you put the contrast 3 to 4 mil. In the balloon first to fix the balloon at the ampulla, you can see the waist, and then you increase the balloon. For EPBD, you increase balloon up to lots of waist and keep the pressure normally more than 7 atm, But for EPLVD, you slowly increase the balloon. The first step, you increase the balloon 3 atm. If you select 12 to 15 millimeter in diameter, when you increase 3 atm, the diameter size is 12 millimeter in diameter, and you keep half to 1 minute, and slowly increase up to 4.5, the diameter up to 13.5, and also half to 1 minute, and then gradually increase up to 8 atm. The final diameter is 15 millimeter diameter. This is the technique for Bailey sphincterplasty. I recommend to have a look in this publication. This by International Consensus Guideline for the technique EPLVD. How to avoid adverse event. I think the three of most adverse event for this technique, the number one, bleeding, is number two, pancreatitis, and number three, perforation. For the bleeding, you need to prepare in case of the patient high risk, for example, cardiomyopathy, cirrhosis, end-stage renal disease, the patient on antiplatelet or anticoagulant, you need to proper prepare already mentioned, and avoid full syncytiotomy. Because in phlebotomy, list of the bleeding and perforation. Mostly for safety, keep the maximum balloon 15 millimeter in diameter. If you decided to increase up to 18 or 20, should be careful because more than 15 increase list of the bleeding and also perforation as well. And the pancreatitis might be minimal in case of EPLVD with prior syncytiotomy compared with the EPBD group. Already mentioned about perforation, keep not full syncytiotomy, just only 50 to 75% only, and the balloon not more than 15 millimeter in diameter, and slowly inflate the balloon to see the waist. If the waist proceeded when you increase the pressure in the balloon, please stop. That means subclinical by the suture. If you increase more, you list up the perforation. Think this is a good publication to show you the factor that predict adverse event. This or fatal perforation. You can see this picture, you can see no obvious CBD. But when you increase the dilate, you can see the waist, and the waist still remain. You can see this also taper CBD, but in this patient, obvious CBD signature. So you can see on the lower panel of the slide, or when you increase the balloon, the waist is not gone, still remain the waist. Please remember, if still remain the waist when you increase the pressure, please stop. If you increase more pressure, you list up the perforation. So in summary, for the syncytiotomy and EPLVD, it's good to get way to therapeutic in the biduct or in the pancreatic duct. Check indication, especially for EPLVD, and check the risk factor and avoid the patient with contraindication. Perform properly technique, that's really, really important. And if you know how to recognize prevention and prompt treatment in case of the adverse event. Hopefully you enjoy this presentation and you can get some small thing to improve your practice. Thank you very much for your kind visit our channel. See you in next FC ERCP series.